The ground rumbled as the cultists' chanting rose in pitch. The sacrifices screamed as their souls were torn through the blasphemous glyphs carved into their flesh. The earth split and crumbled away into nothingness as the profane falsetto reached its highest note, painting the horizon in a horrifying crimson. Thunder bloomed in the distance, and the sky rained fire as the flesh of the sacrifice began to burn with unholy conflagration. Their screams were silenced as the cries of the innocents reached the ears of the fallen, and as the last victims cried themselves hoarse, the world died. Hello there, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Mildra, and I will be your gaming monk for the evening. Last time I talked about how the idea of a post-apocalypse is limited by expectations of what it's supposed to be. This time I want to tackle a different angle with that problem. Instead of the source of the apocalypse, this week leans into the genre issue. You look at most post-apocalyptic works, and they largely lean towards science fiction's ends of the spectrum. While there's a few fantasy apocalypses thrown here and there, for example the previously reviewed Wheelhouse, they're often the exception rather than the rule. Today I'll be delving into another exception in this paradigm with Shattered. Created by Indie Studio, that's I-N-D-E, or It's Never Dark Enough, Shattered can be described as grimdark fantasy where the failed actions of a cult resulted in the most extreme example of may you live in interesting times. How does it hold up? Let's find out. Shattered is a fairly packed book at around 290 pages, but one thing stood out to me. The book's use of contrast, in a sense. With an emphasis on black and red text to draw the eye where needed, and keeping text boxes or sides on black backgrounds. This helps make up for the fact that the book is fairly spread out when it comes to the use of its art, but what art is present is high quality. Last but not least, the all-important index is present. This is a classic case of getting the most from the least, as this is definitely a dialogue-heavy book. Much like Project Biomodus, Shattered uses a experience as currency system, starting with 400 XP. We'll be exploring this with a vampire character named Lamia. Step 1 is to choose a race. Obviously, we'll go with vampire in our case, which aren't exactly the traditional sort of vampires you'd expect. Vampires in Shattered are descended from humans who fled underground and were exposed to corrupting magics and gases, transforming them into something removed from humanity. This choice grants us the following traits: Bloodburn, Bloodlust, The Coven, Darksight, Extremophile, Feared, and Feed. This reflects the ability to see in total darkness but suffer penalties in light, an immunity to most poisons and poison gases, and the benefits of being within a vampiric coven, if we so choose. On the other hand, we suffer damage when exposure to UV light, as UV light turns vampires' blood acidic, and must feed on blood to mitigate some of the disadvantages of, well, being a vampire. Step 2 is stats. Characters in Shattered have 7 stats that start at 2 and are increased with experience. In our case, we'll go with a strength of 3, toughness 3, intelligence 2, willpower 2, perception 3, and charisma 2. Step 3 is combat skills, and these are self-explanatory and are tied to the stat that they're linked to. In our case, we'll go with melee 2, block 2, dodge 2, and ballistic 1. Step 4 is non-combat skills. Like the previous step, these are linked to a stat, but have a different XP expenditure scheme than combat skills. In this case, we'll have athletics, intimidate, acrobatics, and navigation at 1, and awareness at 2. Step 5 is talents. This is going to be the priciest expenditure compared to other parts, and has more stringent requirements. On this section, we have 48 XP in the Muscle talent, 27 in Feral Roar, and 27 in Fortitude. Lastly, equipment. Now we start with 500 notes for our equipment, notes being the currency, obviously. We'll spend this on our starting grade 1 weapon, armor, and shield, along with giving them a few upgrades, a mask, a set of plain clothes, and a spyglass, leaving us with 85 notes as pocket money, essentially. On paper, I'm fine with most of the character creation, save for the one elephant in the room, and that's the talent system. My big problem with it is the requirements. Given the freeform nature of character creation, I feel like the talent system has the same problem that feats had in 3rd edition D&D. Having to pre-plan your attribute and skill layouts in advance in order to qualify for a given talent. Freeform tends to give the message of take whatever you want or make whatever you want. And having these sorts of requirements puts a bottleneck on things. I don't think it's as bad as the feat chains 3rd edition could get, but it's not far off. On the plus side, I will give the progression system credit for throwing a bone for advanced characters. Shattered uses the multi-die system, or MDS. This is a die system that uses die codes based on the total rank of a stat and skill combination, starting at 1d4 and increasing in step up to 1d10 every 5 ranks, creating a die wrap, not too similar to the step system that Earthdawn uses. This is compared to a difficulty level or a contested roll to determine success or failure, with criticals activating when a roll is at least twice that opposing difficulty. Combat is based on an action point system, with all characters starting with 5 action points, while reactions not having an action point cost, something I fully endorse to minimize defensive play. That said, contested rolls are emphasized compared to static defensive numbers, but the long list of actions is one that I'd likely have to summarize at my own table in order to make sure that people just don't use basic attack all the time. The overall system of mechanics feels like there's some DNA from the D20 system. Much of this DNA is avoided, thankfully, but some of it is still present due to the way its crunch is presented. I do think that the multiple die types have the possibility of getting swingy in places, especially with the lack of an overall tiering system. That might be apropos for a grimdark game, but it might make setting up encounters a bit tricky. While the game does have a creature creation system that can make things a little bit more sane, this is going to be a game where the GM is going to have to do some work. However, there's a few sets of talents that aren't exactly standard fare, in particular its casting equivalent talents, which we'll dive into. There are 4 non-standard types of talents: Martial Arts, Arcana, Conviction, and Psi. The simplest of these 4 is Martial Arts, which is split between 3 pillars spread across 10 tiers of talent. The talent used is called Martial Arts Stance, which grants a +1 bonus to damage for unarmed hand-to-hand attacks in that stance. Now, the first pillar of this is Style, which is how the martial artist was trained and grants kata benefits at ranks 2, 6, and 10. The second pillar is Impact, which represents the way the martial artist hits and grants benefits at every odd-numbered rank. Finally, Race, which grants a benefit at ranks 4 and 8 and represents the use of the martial artist's body type. In addition, there's a handful of martial arts talents for further specialization, and this will be a bit of a theme with the remaining ones. Arcana is magic in the traditional sense, kind of. Now, Arcana in Shattered is split into 2 types, Primal Theurgy and Necromancy, with the former being treated as essentially energy magic. Casting doesn't require a pool per se, but each spell has a spell power requirement, which reflects the minimum casting roll result you have to surpass in order to cast the spell safely. On the other hand, casters do have a casting fatigue pool called overcasting, which can be gained from failing a casting roll or boosting the spell power of a roll that you can cast. When this limit is reached, the caster cannot cast spells safely until the points are reduced, usually over a long rest. Conviction can be described as divine magic in Shattered's equivalent, and is used by marshals who represent a given avatar's aspect. These aspects can be elements, concepts, and so on. Now, unless a character has the dualism talent, they can only use one aspect. Now, the effects of conviction, known as miracles, use a resource pool called conviction points. A chosen aspect grants 4 effects. Omens, which are physical tells that don't have a gameplay equivalent, just a narrative equivalent. Scry, a new form of perception that the marshal has. Opposition, which is the aura that weakens them. And graces, which are benefits gained from having conviction ranks at 2, 5, and 9. When it comes to miracles, characters have access to each set of miracles based on their highest conviction rank. Psi, the last one of the bunch, It is equivalent to psionic effects and power, and is a rare ability in the world of Shattered. Like Arcana, Psi is split between two schools, Kinesis and Illusion. Now, instead of using a resource, the limiting factor on using Psi powers is Strain, starting with a base amount and increasing with better effects. But this strain acts as the difficulty roll for the psychic. Failure on this roll causes them to lose 1 point of fatigue, and that is in short supply. Oftentimes, post-apocalyptic or grimdark games want to limit power sandboxes to the players. Shattered is not such a game with its variety of builds, options, systems, and customizations. However, with all that breadth of options comes a price of choice paralysis. This is as far removed from one can get from a beer and pretzels game, especially since there's already a dozen potential actions before you factor in talents. I can see this being a natural fit for those who like making crazy builds and gish characters and or monsters alike. This is ultimately why I was so harsh on the talent system. It's one of those issues that trickles down into other aspects of the game's design. And as I often say, all roads lead to Rome. With that in mind, Shattered gets a final stamp of recommended. If it weren't for the talent issue, I would have put this as a strongly recommended. This is a fairly packed book that has a lot of potential for campaigns in a post-apocalyptic fantasy. However, the options will no doubt be intimidating for those who prefer affairs that are lighter on crunch. It's funny to cover this after Biomodus because the two of them are on similar grounds in terms of their philosophy, almost a Venn diagram of sorts.